So in this PowerPoint 2016 animation tutorial, I am going to show you how to create this simple ice cream animated loader. So stay tuned as I will be right back. Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. So let's get started. Go to the file menu and then click new and then choose blank presentation and then change the layout to blank. From the home tab, click the layout drop down button and choose blank. And if you want, you can also collapse this thumbnail view so you may have more area to view. And let me move this presentation to the second screen. That's fine. So here I am going to choose a shape from the insert tab, click the shapes drop down button and choose rounded corner rectangle and draw it right over here and use the yellow handler to resize the shape. I don't want too much rounded corner at the bottom of this shape, so I will draw another rounded corner rectangle at the bottom, just like that. And that's fine. And going to reduce the rounded corners by holding the yellow handler. That's fine. And now I'm going to remove the outline of both of these rectangles by clicking on the shape outline drop down button from the format tab and then choose no outline. Let me tell you one more thing, that I want to remove the outline of this second rectangle as well. So as soon as I select this rectangle, I don't need to go again to the shape outline. I can also press the F4 key and that will repeat my last command, which was no outline. So as soon as I will press the F4 key, it will remove the outline. Now I'm going to draw the sticks, and for that I am again going to choose the rounded corner rectangles and draw it right over here. Use the yellow handler, and if you want to remove the top part of the rounded corner rectangle, then I can also draw another rectangle over here, this time straight corner rectangle, and draw it like this and hold down the previous, select the previous rectangle and then hold down the shift key and then select the rectangle on top, and from the format tab click the merge shapes drop down button and use subtract. And that will remove the remaining part of the rectangle. And now I will go place it right here. Resize it. Zoom in a little bit and adjust this rectangle as well. That's fine. And send this rectangle at the back. From the format tab, click send to back. And remove the outline as well. And for shadow, I am going to draw another rectangle here. That's fine. Remove the outline and change the color. I'm going to take a color palette which I have drawn already. And for shadow, I will choose shape fill, eyedropper, and will choose this color. And for stick color, I'm going to choose again eyedropper, and this time I am going to select this one. Now I am going to draw bars that will move through the ice cream, and for that I am going to take another rectangle here, draw a larger rectangle larger than the ice cream and rotate it and place it just right over here. Now choose again the shape fill eyedropper, and this time I am going to choose the first color and remove the outline. Make a duplicate of this bar by holding the control and shift keys and then drag and drop. Again choose the eyedropper and repeat the same steps to create two more bars. That's fine. Now place each bar on top of the previous one, and you can also hold down the Alt key to adjust the bars precisely. That's fine. Now select all these bars by holding the Shift key from the keyboard and make a group of them from the Format tab. Click the Group drop down button and choose Group. Now I will create 3 copies of this grouped object. From the Home tab, click Copy and then Paste. And now you don't need to click Copy and Paste again and again. You can only click the Paste button twice. Now I will place all these bars on top of each other. Hold down the Alt key. That way the objects will move according to your mouse movements. Now select all of these objects by holding the Shift key and make a group of all of them. Place it sideways. Now I am going to draw a slight size rectangle. Go to the Insert tab, click Shapes, then take a straight corner rectangle and draw it over the slide. Change the fill color. I am going to take the darker one and send it to back and remove the outline color. Now what I am going to do is I am going to subtract the ice cream part from the larger rectangle, and for that I will first select the large rectangle, hold down the Shift key, then select the top part of the ice cream and then bottom part of the ice cream, and from the merge shapes you subtract, and that will remove the ice cream part from the larger rectangle. And I am going to adjust this one a little bit here, just right here. Hold down the Alt key if you want. That's fine. Now I am going to place these bars on top of the ice cream and will then send them back to the larger rectangle. As you can see that the ice cream part has been subtracted, and that way you see the objects behind the larger rectangle. Now go to the Animation tab, click Add Animation and choose More Motion Paths and apply Diagonal Down Right Path, and now adjust the length and the position of the path, and I will adjust it right here. You can also hold down Alt key when adjusting the motion paths. Click Animation Pan. I want to start this animation with previous with a duration of 5 seconds, and open the effect options by right clicking on the effect and choose effect options, or you can also double click on the effect to open the effect options dialog window. I don't need any smoothness here, so I will move them and want to repeat this animation until end of the slide. Let's see the preview. As you can see that the animation is in continuous loop and is very precisely moving along, and that is because of the motion path length and direction. Finally, I am going to insert the word art. From the Insert tab, choose Word Art and type the text you want. And place it anywhere you want. Change the font color. I would also like to apply a shadow to the text. That's fine. Now go to the Animation tab again and click Add Animation, and this time I am going to choose Fade with Previous with the duration of 2 seconds. Open the Effect options. I want to animate the text by letter with a delay of 5% between each letter, and want to repeat this animation until end of the slide. And finally, I would also like to add a font color animation with previous with a duration of 1.5 seconds. Open the effect options. auto reverse smooth hand, and I want to choose this color style with a delay of 3% between each letter, and would like to repeat this animation until end of the slide. Now let's see the final preview, and here we have the ice cream animation. And I hope you will find this video informative and interesting. Let me know by leaving your valuable comments and by liking and sharing this video with your friends. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.